HACCP study. What is the HACCP meeting? HACCP or Hazard and Probability study is the structural analysis of the system, process, or operation carried out by the multidisciplinary team, such as a process engineer, instrument engineer, piping engineer, and etc. The primary purpose of the HACCP study is to identify and evaluate the hazard within the plant process or in the operation. The hazards may be several impact, including to impact to the people, impact to the property, environment, or social. A HACCP study is often used to identify the significant operability or quality problem, including significant operability problem, such as the isolation problem, preparation, or removal for maintenance. HACCP is done by using a set of the drivers in a combination with the system parameter to seek the meaningful deviation from the design intention. HACCP in the project life. The main use of HACCP study in the process industrial are for the new design, process, and operation, both continued and batch process, and for modification of the existing plant and process. So HACCP study is always mandatory required during the detailed engineering stage for the new plant modification or expansion of the existing plant or process, as per the picture below. Compare HACCP and what if. HACCP or hazard operability review technique need a moderate level of skill to implement. The HACCP review is a systematic process which has to conduct in a proper fashion and accurate record in order to perform the HACCP review. A special team leader is typically use a standard guideword or deviation to review a team during the process. The summary compare between the what if analysis and HACCP as shown in the table. HACCP is not required experience based because we use the standard guideword to guide the participant in the meeting. What if yes, because otherwise the question in the meeting will be fully open and is it difficult to cross in the meeting? Systematic, yes, HACCP is very systematic system. What if partially? Speed, HACCP is very slow because we have a lot of the guidework to be studied. What if fast to implement? Skill, HACCP require moderate. What if maybe low if it combined with the checklist? Flexible, both of study are flexible to do in any state of the engineering, but HACCP is normally mandatory required during detailed engineering. HACCP workflow. First one, specify the section or node to be examined. Describe and discuss the process condition, step of operation, determine the design intent. Next one, select a parameter, process a parameter, flow, pressure, temperature, level. Then combine this parameter with the guideword to develop a meaningful deviation combined with the high, mid, high, low, less than something. Then seek a possible cause of deviation and identify the consequence. Check the availability of the existing safeguard and decide if they are adequate or if an additional safeguard is necessary. Evaluate the severity without considering the presence of existing safeguard. It means we will study what is the maximum possible outcome. Next one, evaluate the likelihood of the cause. Then we can determine the risk of incident. Next one, we have to review, ensure on cause of deviation has been considered. Go back to the guideword. Combination with the parameter to give the credible deviation. Are there the further parameter to be considered? Then everything finished. We can say this node is finished. Example HACCP worksheet. You can see we have a column of the parameter, driver deviation, cost, consequence, safeguard, severity, likelihood, leak sinking, recommendation. Parameter, we use the process parameter, such as the flow, pressure level, guidewords. We have the standard guidewords, such as a no, high, low, less. After combination with the parameter and guide word, we call it deviation. No follow. Then the chairman will ask about the cause in the meeting. Then participant shall give the answer. For example, cause of no flow from outlet line plug, maybe from the fluid itself. Then what is the maximum consequence? Maximum consequence such as the system pressure increase, potential of the vessel rupture, and loss of containment. Then what is the existing safeguard? So it means every person have to look at the PAD at the moment. What is the overpressure protection that is available in the PAD right now? So, okay, for example, we had the PSV. Then we think about the safety. During consider about safety, we consider without using the safeguard. So it means if system overpressure and loss of containment, safety is 5. Likelihood, we have to check the experience of the people. Okay, they may say something. Then we think about the risk ranking. If it's not enough, we have to push some recommendation. Example has sub question. Parameter 4, guide was no. Example, block valve outlet is closed. Wrong write up by operator. Control valve fail closed. Power failure. Or incorrectly install a check valve. Input data to be prepared for the HAZOP meeting. The important one is piping and instrument diagram for main process or piping and instrument diagram for the vendor package. Plot plan, process flow diagram, process description, cause and effect diagram with schedule of alarm and trip set point, control narrative, equipment data sheet, and material safety data sheet. This is the most used information during the HAZOP meeting. Thank you for watching my video and see you on next video.